before getting over there, generally when we get into IIT, we all have same type of thoughts, right? Because in school, people will be like, you give your 10th exam, everything, you are, your life is settled. You do well there, your life is settled. We believe in that. We go for 12th exam, again, the same thing. Then they say, okay, do JEE preparation. You get into IIT and your life will be settled. But after you actually get into IIT, I mean, you guys are here for 1 year. Can you say that it is settled? People say that, like, getting into IIT and pose that your life will be like a cakewalk, like you will have all job offers coming in and it's going to be much easier. Yes, we do have upper hand compared to a lot of other colleges, but I wouldn't say that, you know, that it's a cakewalk or something. You still have to prepare towards it and you have to kind of be tactical in terms of how you approach for your career or in general placements. Now, just a little bit about me, how I started, when I started concentrating on placements and so on. So I joined IIT in 2011. When you join, like, I think you guys are yet to go to the campus. I'm hoping that in another few months, or at least in like 6 months or a year, things become normal and you guys can actually go to INSTI. But when you go there, it's like very overwhelming, right? There are a lot of things going on. You are in a hostel, you are away from your parents, you are preparing for a lot of courses, you have labs and whatnot, right? So obviously it's very overwhelming. And I thought that, okay, throughout my childhood, I have been like academically oriented, I have gotten good marks and all, so I will do well in INSTI also. But sadly, that didn't happen. I was shocked to see my CGPA after first semester. In fact, after the initial quizzes, I even went to some profs and asked them that I've always been good at studies. So what happened? Like, why am I getting D grade and what a C grade and all that? And I actually studied. I remember in first year, we had C++. I don't know, you guys still have that course as a part of your common courses? Do you guys have it?
We have C language, Introduction to Programming in C.
Okay. Yeah, so we also had that. And we had this book called Let Us See, which I read 3 times. So it was not like I was not putting in effort, but generally, right, like everyone is intelligent around. So it's very difficult to kind of do certain things. So obviously I was like, okay, fine, this first semester, let me do, you know, still concentrate on studies and I will do well next time. Now what happens is, and I don't know if you guys know, but when you apply for any PORs, like Shastra Saran happens in your second semester. So that means you have to apply for becoming a volunteer in your first semester. To become a volunteer, there is a CGPA criteria. So you need to have above 7 CGPA to apply for certain things, because INSTI generally thinks like you shouldn't be neglecting your ACADS and doing extracurricular activities, right? So since I was below 7, I didn't apply for anything like Shastra, Sarang and all that. Okay, my CGPA improved a little bit, but by the end of second sem, it wasn't like I was having a good CGPA, neither I had done any volunteership in Shastra Sarang, I didn't have any PORs. Only thing I was part of was the dance team. So that is how I had some connection with the seniors and people from other branches, right? Then I was like, okay, fine. Let me just concentrate on studies. All these PORs and all will come later. I will just study hereafter. And this is what happened after my third semester. I did study. My GPA went down to 6.8. And as you see, the CGPA is 6.96, right? Now the same cycle follows. Again, when you are in your third semester, you have to apply for courtships. So in your first year, you will be applying for volunteership in Shastra Sarang. In your third sem, you will be applying for becoming a cord. Since I had not done any POR, my CGPA was not good, you kind of start getting this, really bad feeling about yourself. All the other people from your branch, other branch are getting very good marks. They are into a lot of other extracurricular activities. Some are in inter-IIT teams, some are doing, you know, some other thing. So at the end of my third semester, I was really in bad stage, where I didn't think I will be able to, you know, do anything from placement or any of that perspective. So I'm just highlighting this because it isn't like everyone knows everything right from the time they get into. But the idea is that you at least learn from others' mistake and you kind of try to, you know, change it for yourself. You don't have time to make same mistakes again. So at this stage, right, I was trying to understand from my seniors, my department seniors, through my dance team, I knew seniors of other branches who will be in like their fourth year, fifth year. So I used to ask them, what is it important, how you manage, what you do, what all things to do, right? So from there is how I started getting fun days. So fun days, I don't know if you guys know, it's an insti name for whatever I'm doing right now. So they used to give me fun days, do this, do that, this matters, that matters. And then I thought, okay, I mean, if I continue to do like this, I wouldn't, you know, reach anywhere. So that's when I started concentrating on the important things and, you know, decided that I need to change things for myself. So luckily, after putting in some efforts, by fourth sem, I was in a stage where I was able to at least eligible to apply to a lot of things. So there was obviously a huge jump from my 6.8 GPA to 8.14. It's not like I study hard or anything, right? I just, through my friends and all, figured out what is important that you need to study, how to make sure that you get a good CGPA. Now, by my first year or I think second year, I was sure that I am not really enjoying my core branch. So, but I didn't know what else, like I didn't like core, but I don't know what else I should be doing. I didn't like coding also, as I told, I read the C, Let Us See book like some 3 times and I got C grade. So definitely was not my cup of tea. But then because seniors and all used to give me fun days, I started exploring other things. So I think you would have seen in the poster that I have sent across, but basically I just tried my hand at each and everything that's possible. So later in my 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th semester, so I've done BTech, right? So it was 4 years. So I was part of dance team. You see here is Sino, who is there in the call right now. He's also my husband. I was part of inter-IIT team. So this is a photo from IIT Guwahati, where we had gone to represent IIT Madras. And I was part of the badminton team. This is my photo from a summit in Philippines, where it was a social entrepreneurship related summit and you had to basically represent your university there. This is my photo from placement team. I don't know, you guys can see me. But basically the reason I'm showing you all of this is though right now you guys are at home, but in the next few months or at least for sure in a year, you guys will be going to INSTI. And I just want to show you a glimpse of how it is going to be and just try and explore and enjoy as much as you can for that, right? This last one is a photo of my class. So I am here. The reason I'm showing this photo is because I talk to a lot of second years from IIT Madras, like current second years, and I was asking them, whom are you close with from your branch, right? And their answer was like, no, I'm not friends with my branch mates. I'm only friends with like my friends from 11th and 12th. That's because we studied together, we did JEE preparation. So after coming to IIT also, I'm hanging out with them only. But I think while you can continue to have that friendship, you should make sure that you have a good circle within your branch as well. And the reason is only in the first year, you guys have common courses, right? So you are all together. It is not dependent on which branch it is. You guys are together for many courses. But as you go to your second year, third year, fourth year, it's essentially your branch people that will be with you in the classes. And if you don't know anyone there, it's just going to make it really difficult for you because you might need notes from them. You might need fundings from them. If someone applies for some internship, which is related to your core department, you should know about it. But if you guys don't talk to each other, it's going to be difficult. So this was like a small family that we had. This is my branch photo. And while I'll be giving a lot of placement fundings, but I just want to highlight that placement is one part of it. So try to make sure that you explore other things also and make maximum use of the time, even now that you are online, because you guys are at home, you don't have to suffer from the mess food, so that's really good for you. But when you go there, obviously, I'm sure you will, you know, experience all these things.